saints have dwelt secure. Sufficient is your love alone, and our defense is sure. Before the hills in order stood, on earth received its rain. From everlasting you are God, to endless is the same.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the
majesty and sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. The word of the Lord.
Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Oh, tremble before him all the earth. Say to the nations, the Lord is king. He will judge the peoples in fairness. Give the Lord glory and
the beginning of the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the Church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace and peace be with you. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters, loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in prayer and in the Holy Spirit with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Oh. gates of the world as you hold on to the word of life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, and you are not concerned with anyone's opinions, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us, then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this, and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord.
I think one thing most people have in common is, on one level or another, we have an interest in money. And sometimes it can affect the way we react to persons, to things, to certain situations. When I was studying in Italy, my aunt and uncle came to visit me. This was in the 80s, before Italy went to the euro, still the lira. And my uncle, to put it kindly, was very, very careful with money. In fact, he drove his wife to work every morning. It was her place of employment was on the way to where he worked, but he charged her mileage. And it goes on from there. But when they were in Italy, we were at a beach location, and we were walking by a very nice store, and there was a towel in the window, and my aunt didn't have a towel with her, and so I told her, "Well, it's not very expensive. It's 10,000 lira, which at that time was about $6. My uncle thought that was way too much, but they splurged. And when we had passed the shop, it was after a very long Italian lunch, a couple hours, a couple bottles of wine. And what I failed to see on the price, paid for it with a credit card, was one extra zero. So it was 100,000 lira, not 10,000, which would have been about $60. And he didn't discover that until they got back to their hotel and he looked at the receipt. And I heard about that for about 5 or 6 years after that. It was a nice towel, but it was definitely, and I had to agree with them, not worth $60. But money is interesting, and how money looks is interesting too. In terms of design, I think it says something. It says something about who uses it. When the euro was created for the European Union, they had a contest to choose a design for the bills. And the winner of the contest proposed European architectural periods. Because the euro is used in so many different European countries, they didn't want to put a particular person on it. So they put on it something that they all shared, architectural style. So for the 5 euro, the design was classical Greece, the 10 Romanesque, the 20 Gothic, all the way up to the 500th bill, which I think was 20th century modern architecture. But the bills were, and the design was to convey a common heritage that they all shared in kind of a tangible way, seen in the buildings in European cities. So when you have a 50 euro in your wallet, it's not just paper. In some way, you're connected to the heritage of the Renaissance. That was the thinking, anyway. When the US dollar was created, you probably know, there was also some controversy in what was going to be on the dollar, the various denominations. But it was decided that it would contain presidents, and with some exceptions, like Hamilton, of course, and Franklin. But it would contain presidents and the U.S. seal, which, you know, if you look at a dollar bill, portrays an unfinished pyramid with 13 rows. And above the pyramid is the all-seeing eye. And that all-seeing eye represents God, represents providence, overseeing it all. And this, the symbolism, it is I think, important. It symbolizes the United States. The United States is watched over by an all-seeing, all-knowing God. And you can't miss it, because it says very clearly, in God we trust on our money. And the dollar in your wallet is currency that you can buy things with, but it is also, I think, a little bit of a touch with our history, with our common history. Which leads me to Jesus in today's gospel and his very, very clever rebuttal of the trap set by the Pharisees. The power of the state in Jesus' time, as in ours, includes the authority to collect taxes. And in Jesus' time, also enforce it through threats of legal sanctions, or even violence to the body if necessary. And the question was, either Jesus supports Rome or he loses face with the crowd who resents Roman rule. And today Jesus might say to us, pull out a dollar bill and tell me who is on that dollar. You know, it's George Washington, and on the back you have the eye of God watching over us all. But in Jesus' time, pulling out that coin was very problematic, not for Jesus so much, but for the Pharisees. And I think we can know what the crowd around Jesus was feeling, because the coin in use not only held an image of Caesar, but the coin also had the words in Latin, Tiberius Caesar, August son of the divine Augustus, Pontificus Maximus, high priest. So, the Pharisee that was carrying around that coin was actually breaking 2 of the 10 commandments by carrying this coin. Thou shalt not make a graven image, and thou shalt not have any other god before me. Jesus uses that coin which people considered blasphemous, but he uses it to make a very, very important point, a significant point, to give to God what is God's, what belongs to God, and to Caesar what belongs to him. That's what he says. Give to God what belongs to God, and to Caesar what belongs to him. But how do we differentiate what belongs to God, what belongs to Caesar? How are we to render unto God what belongs to him? What are we to render? And I think Jesus would say, very simply, everything. Everything belongs to the Father. And Jesus, I don't think, is saying, you know, that this stuff over here belongs to Caesar and Rome, and this stuff over here belongs to God. It all belongs to God. And so his answer is rather subversive. It's very clever. It's very subversive. It's a little seed buried in Jesus' answer that probably the Pharisees had to think about as they walked away. Caesar can say anything that he wants on his coin. But God has already stamped the divine image on the human soul. God's image is stamped on you and on me, on all of us. And we are like a coin in a certain sense, because by God's grace, we are stamped with the image of God on us. And that is what gives us our ultimate value, an undeniable, a precious value. And civil authority isn't, well, civil authority is, of course, a necessary reality of life. And especially now during these troubled times, we have to remember not to forget that we belong to God. We belong to the Father. And when your being is filled with God, and I think we realize who ultimately we belong to, then real love can exist. And real love brings all kinds of possibilities. So rendering unto Caesar's means we have responsibilities to civil authority, to abide by the law, to participate in the life of the community. But if we render unto God what is God's, then everything, money, politics, our lives, all of it has a divine stamp on it, and something that we cannot forget, something that has implications far-reaching into our lives. We pray that the Lord will continue to enlighten us, continue to help us to remember who exactly we are and how we are bound together by love of God, by love of neighbor. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. ascended into heaven. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. He with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. We place all of our needs now before a loving and merciful God.
For the Church, through its ministries throughout the world, may it help repay its great debt owed to our Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For missionaries, may they never lose heart and always be a sign of hope to those whom they minister. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every little child, and especially those who live in their mother's womb, that they might grow in the image and likeness of God who made them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are sick or suffering will find strength in God's grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us in death, Chateau, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For the prayers and the prayer intention, and for the prayers